Hey guys, Eric Tarr here for theproaudiophiles.com. This is the second of a three-part series on creating a drum mix using FXpansion's BFD3 and iZotope's Alloy 2. In this video, I will be focusing on mixing the individual drum tracks using Alloy 2. Right now I've recorded the samples of the individual microphones from BFD3 onto separate audio tracks in Pro Tools. Now I can mix the multi-track recording as if it were a regular drum session. In order to save on CPU processing, I'm going to make the instrument track with BFD3 inactive. Next, I'll start out by making a rough mix of the session, adjusting some levels and pans. For reference in the future, I'm going to print this rough mix so that I can compare my final mix with where I started. I went ahead and printed the stereo track here. Next, let's get started mixing with Alloy 2. I'm going to go ahead and insert the plugin on the first slot of each track. Next, I'll go track by track and dial in the starting point for each microphone. For the kick-in microphone, I'm going for a sharp sound with a lot of attack. Therefore, I'm going to control the dynamics of each drum hit so that the sustain is decreased and the attack is increased. Then I'm going to roll off the low end and add some upper mids. For the kick-out microphone, I'm going for that thick, low end of the kick drum. Therefore, I'm going to squash the transient of the drum and tighten up the sustain. Next, I'm going to scoop out the low mids and add some extra bottom end. For the snare top microphone, I'm going to process the signal to get some extra smack out of it. This involves some compression on the transient and decreasing the envelope sustain. Next, I'm going to fill out the bottom of the tone with a touch of EQ. for the snare bottom microphone, I want to get a lot of crisp attack out of it. Therefore, I'm going to gate it pretty abruptly so that the snare sizzle mostly comes in as soon as the drum is hit. For the snare side microphone, I'm looking to dial in the tone and sustain of the drum. This involves some EQ to bring out the harmonics of the drum and also lengthen the sustain. For the hi-hat, I really just want to roll off the low end and top end so that it doesn't sound too harsh. Next up are my toms. For now, I'm just going to give them a touch of EQ and compression to polish the sound and keep the dynamics under control. For the overheads, I'm going to roll off the low end. Next, I'm going to use a trick with a de-esser to really act as a de-harsher to keep the cymbals under control. For my room mics and ambient mics, I'm going to treat them differently. Starting with the room mics, I'm going to overcompress them and give them a lot of dirt, distortion, and overdrive as a special effect. Then for my ambient mics, I'm going to keep them more natural and just add some EQ. Now I can work on blending the two together depending on if I want more or less of that over-the-top rock sound. Finally, what I'll do is bring back the entire mix together so I can hear everything in context. Then, it's a matter of making minor tweaks to add to the overall sound. In my next video, I'm going to demonstrate some bus processing on the drum mix using Alloy 2 to finish everything up. Take care, guys.